This lesson explores fluid friction. Any substance that flows is a fluid. This includes gases, including air, and liquids, including water. It can also include solids like plastic when they are melted, because that time they also start to flow. We know that air is light, but it exerts a frictional force on objects when they move through it. When space shuttles re-enter the Earth's atmosphere, the air friction is the main cause that the nose of the space shuttle gets very hot. In fact, it reaches temperatures more than 1500 degrees Celsius. Friction is also exerted on objects moving through water and other liquids. All fluids exert a force of friction on an object when it moves through it. This frictional force on the object moving through a fluid depends on the object's speed with respect to the fluid. The frictional force also depends on the shape of the object. The frictional force also depends on the nature of the fluid, its density or viscosity. Fluid friction depends on the size of the object. In nature, most of the animals like birds and fish seem to have evolved over time to be designed to offer minimum friction. If you notice the shape, most of them have what is called a streamlined shape that helps them move through air or water easily. When we consider streamline through the air, it comes under the topic of aerodynamics. Reasons for streamlining. Look at this rectangle. If it is moving through a fluid in this direction, then the fluid will be hitting it from the opposite direction. And the smaller this surface will be, lesser will be the surface on which the fluid can hit it. So to reduce the friction, best would be to reduce the surface also into a point. But that's not all. Streamlined shape, like in a fish, not only means the front surface is reduced, it also means that the last point of the surface is also minimum. That way the object cuts through the fluid and helps the fluid to come back as it was before once the object has passed through it. Here you can see this shape is cutting neatly through the water and with least friction. This shape is used in many things because it uses the least amount of energy to move through a fluid. If the back is something like this, then it creates more disturbance in the water, adding to the friction in the fluid. And that's also called drag. Here you can see the turbulence that is happening behind the boat. This adds to the drag or the friction that the object is facing. Now, since objects like cars and planes or boats have to move through fluids like air and water, because of fluid friction, they lose a lot of energy. So a lot of efforts are made to reduce fluid friction. Here's a new setup that will help us actually see how different shapes reduce fluid friction in water. We had this round tub we use for bubble jail for our stage shows. In this, now we have put water, and this structure holds different shapes in place, and the frictional force caused by the moving water on these shapes will be transferred to the spring balance in this way. The propeller powered by the drill machine will make the water move with a constant current. Sadly, the movement of water was not smooth, but it did the job of explaining how the shapes made a difference. This thin canoe shape offered the least friction, always less than 50 grams on the spring balance. Now we hook on the wider canoe shape and get the water to the same speed. It reached a high of 100 grams. This is to show you that only the shape was changed, rest everything remains the same every time we change the shape. This very wide canoe shape reached highs of 150 grams worth of frictional resistance. This regular motorboat shape is not too bad. It showed a reading of 100 grams. Now the main test. What if we reverse the shape of a motorboat? Let's see. This boat found it really difficult to withstand the forces. It almost sank. The reading showed between 200 to 250 grams. So we saw how the shape made a difference when it was moving through water. Now let's see how shapes make a difference when they're moving through air. I made a platform with wheels. And on that, there is a sheet of metal again that will be used to create various shapes using shape thermocol. We tie it to the same structure since we have it now, and we'll use this strong leaf blower to throw high pressure air on it. Let's start with this very streamlined shape. It's like a sports car. The frictional forces show a reading little above 50 grams on the spring balance. Now I'll change the shape to increase the frictional forces. Once again, if you see, the weight remains almost exactly the same, but the shape is less streamlined. It's now like a regular car. The reading is around 75 to 80 grams. Now let's see a much fatter shape, like a minivan. The reading is around 100 grams. Now let's reverse it again, and it's like an old-fashioned bus now. The reading here showed almost 200 grams. This is why no vehicles are now shaped like this from the front, because it causes a lot of fluid friction. These experiments showed how different shapes cause different amounts of friction that the object faced when going through the two fluids. When it comes to flying, there's a very interesting quote. Aerodynamically, the bumblebee shouldn't be able to fly, but the bumblebee doesn't know it, so it goes on flying anyway. But it's not true. If the bee was flying like a plane through the air, then the aerodynamics of the bee might have made it impossible to fly. But the bee flies differently. They flap their wings in a certain way 250 times a second, and that creates mini hurricanes that help lift the bees upwards, and that's how they fly. Now, this is an experiment to show how friction increases with the density of a fluid. In this tube, we will take three fluids with three different densities, and we'll move the same object through it with equal speed using gravity. And we'll time it. The one that takes the longest will mean it exerts the most friction. The first one is already done because there was air in it, and it took 0.3 seconds between the red tapes. In the second, we use water. Let's see. It takes 0.44 seconds. In the third one, we use a very thick liquid, dishwashing soap. Let's see what happens now. It's really taking its own sweet time. It almost took 3 seconds. That's a huge amount of friction that we've revealed here. This experiment showed how the density of the fluid affected the friction. As it got dense, there was more friction. This experiment will show how the size of the object makes a difference. In the same soap solution, we can see once more how long the battery takes. Now I'll remove it so that there's only the clip that has to move through the liquid. Therefore, the size of the object has reduced. Let's see if it takes the same time. It took less time because fluid friction could act on a much lesser surface area. Let's do a quick recap and then we can move on to the DIY of the lesson. Fluid friction. What is fluid friction? Any substance that flows is a fluid. This includes gases and liquids. Even solids in their molten state can be called fluids. Air exerts frictional force on objects when they move through it. In fact, all fluids exert a force of friction on an object when it moves through it. Friction in fluids is also called drag or drag force. Fluid friction or drag acts in the direction opposite to the direction of the motion of the object. Factors affecting fluid friction. Fluid friction depends on the speed of the object going through the fluid. It depends on the shape and the size of the object going through the fluid. It also depends on the nature of the fluid, its density or viscosity. Fluid friction depends on the size of the object. Disadvantages of fluid friction. Fluid friction reduces the speed of the object since it is acting opposite to the motion of the object. The objects lose some energy to overcome fluid friction and therefore the efficiency is reduced. Fluid friction can be reduced by streamlining. This is done by reducing the surface area of the object so that it moves through the fluid smoothly. In nature, most animals like birds and fish are streamlined so that they face less fluid friction. Streamlining through the air comes under the topic of aerodynamics. Most vehicles built for speed are streamlined, like race cars, speedboats, aeroplanes, rockets, and missiles. Here's one look at all of these. In the DIY of this project, I will show you how we made this setup, and I will show you how to do a few extra experiments to show all the three factors that affected friction: density, shape, and speed. This project could be done in a group for a school project since it involves many steps and many things need to be made. Initially, we considered using a tall glass, but then too much liquid gets used here and the experiment becomes unnecessarily more expensive. So we saw many bottles, but either they were too short or too fat. We needed a long container so that the object moves for a little while, and it should be slim so that we don't waste too much liquid. Someone suggested a pipe, and that was a great idea. But this first one was too thin to put an object inside. It's difficult to find a transparent fat pipe, but we found one. This is 3 centimeters in diameter. It was perfect. Now we needed something to hold it straight. So we bought this 60 centimeter long aluminium channel. It's an H section channel, as you can see. It's perfect because we can rest the pipe along the channel and tape it up in various places. Now you need to bend the pipe towards the outside of the curved shape and clip it with a strong clip. Don't tape it because we need to remove it many times. You'll see later. Generally, most pipes are curved because it's kept in a roll. We now need to place the curve facing the channel and leave about 10 centimeters from the end. Now cut the extra pipe. Keep a scissors at home only for DIY projects because thicker materials can spoil the scissors. Now tape these two in the beginning and three other places, and then you can tape it more if you want, but use a transparent tape. Make sure you don't press the pipe too hard while taping or it will get squashed. Cut out the back part of the tapes and stick them to the sides. Now that we have the main part ready, we need to make a base to make it stand. We are using the same base that we made in the previous project. If you haven't made it earlier, then you can follow it in the DIY from that project from lesson number 5. If your aluminium section doesn't fit, then I'm sure you can figure out some other way to fix it to the same base. Now we need a small pulley to make the motion smooth, and this one is from the hardware store. It's the wheel that is used in sliding windows. This will let the thread go from one side of the channel to the other. You can simply use a needle and a very strong thread to fix it to the pipe. I'm not gluing it because we need to keep moving it when we put different objects in the pipe, and it's not easy, but then it's always possible. Be very careful or ask an adult to do this. Now tie it securely. Now we'll make the three objects. First is a big ball bearing, and all you need to do is take a strong synthetic thread around it and wind it up once or twice and ask someone to put a drop of glue that is used for plastics. Once again, be very careful, or best is to ask an adult to do this part, because these glues can stick your fingers very badly. So don't let it come near your fingers. Now make a loop, and this one is done. Now we have to make a flatter object. These came from a basic mechanic toy kit and they add up to the same weight as the ball. Tie one end of all of them together. Make a loop on the thread and tape all of them at the other end. If you leave a tape like this, then it's always easy to take out the next time. And this one is ready also. Now we need something that's flat on top and cylindrical. And again, it should be the same weight. A regular pencil cell suited perfectly. Tie the thread again in this way or any other way. And make a loop. The extra thread can be knotted and cut off, and this is ready too. Now for the main counterweight, we needed a heavier weight. Find a big bolt with a nut. These washers are just to add a little more weight, but not really necessary. Tie a 1 meter long and strong thread using the nut itself. Now you have to take it through the pulley wheel exactly as shown. Then you pull the side of the bolt, and when the bolt just starts hanging, that's where you have to tie the thread into a loop on the other side of the pipe. Now you need to put a clip on it. This type of clips are found in identity cards and tags which hang around the neck. Now you can put the different objects easily onto this clip. If the thread goes off the pulley, put it back on. You can use a small wire to help you do that. Keep checking it because this can happen again as well. So this is what we have till now. Just tilt the pipe structure so that it leans forward a bit. This is so that the object inside will not get dragged along the side of the pipe. Now with the colored tape, put a start and a stop point like I'm doing here. Make sure it's not too close to the top or bottom. There, the setup is ready. This is how you can pour the liquids by moving the pulley aside. And this is how you can remove the liquids easily. That's why we used a clip. So So earlier we had done the experiment to show that as the fluid got dense, the friction increased. Now we'll first show how a shape makes a difference. So we'll put a flat shape into the same soap solution. The ball had earlier taken almost 3 seconds. This one takes just around 1.68 seconds because it's very slim and more streamlined in a way. Now let's try the flat top cylindrical shape. Ideally, it should take the longest. Wow, it took 4.28 seconds. Clearly, streamlining had helped to reduce the friction earlier. Now, since it's flat in the front, the friction is really high and the object is going really slow. Now we'll see how the speed of the objects affects friction. You need to add a spring balance on the thread instead of the weight. The DIY of the spring balance is in our regular videos on the channel and the link is also in the description below. Tie the spring balance in almost the same part of the thread where the bolt was attached. Now once you can pull slowly and see what the reading shows. It showed a reading of about 200 grams on the spring balance. Slightly faster, it goes to about 350 grams. And when I pull it really fast, it went up to 500 grams. Hence proving that the higher the speed of the object, more the friction. The DIY as we showed it was the easiest way to make it. But if you want to make it good looking, all you need to do is paint all the metal parts well. Here the metal parts as well as the parts that go inside are all finished nicely. Things required for the TIY project: transparent plastic pipe around 60 cm long, an aluminium channel around 60 cm long, butterfly clip, it should be a big one, scissors, transparent tape, a hammer, sliding window wheel, needle and a strong thread, big ball bearing around 15 mm in diameter, strong synthetic thread, glue for plastic, flat metal pieces from a toy set, used AA battery, big bolt and a nut around 120 mm long and 8 mm in diameter, a small clip or a mini carabiner, insulation tape, bowls or container for liquids, water, dishwashing soap, spring balance, pipe structure from the previous project to be used as a base. After all this friction, now I need to stop a little bit. Hope you enjoyed this lesson as well. The next lesson introduces sound. See you there.